Last night, a man called Behrouz Boochani arrived in New Zealand. There are millions of refugees in the world. The UNHCR has paperwork on 3.9 million refugees. And many have taken extraordinary, exhausting, terrible, terrifying, bewildering, dangerous journeys. But Behrouz Boochani has come to New Zealand having fled authorities in Iran over a period of 6.5 years. And for most of that time, he's been in Australian detention centres. Christmas Island at first. I went there. It's a terrible detention centre to be in. Then Manus Island, having been picked up by the Australian Navy in the sea between Australia and Indonesia and held without trial, without any criminal record of any sort, in a kind of hell of nothingness. But he began to write and write, and this extraordinary book, No Friends But the Mountains, came from some of those words sent out of Manus text by text on WhatsApp. Right as we speak, he's landing in Christchurch, and waiting to meet him at the airport is the city's mayor, who has her own extraordinary backstory, which we will get to. Lianne Dalziel. Mayor Dalziel, welcome. This is a pretty amazing morning, isn't it? And so surprising and unexpected.
It is, John, and it's an extraordinary day. And I'll tell you that on the way here to the airport, I sort of felt as if all the stars had aligned. It's the most glorious day. The sun is shining, not a breath of wind. It's a beautiful Christchurch November day, and it will be a very warm welcome indeed.
And he can go wherever he wants. If he wants to drive over to Akaro or head into the mountains or whatever, he is a free man.
Well, it's the struggle for freedom that drives refugees, and you know, and to know that, you know, he touches down in a city that is a free city and a free country, you know, I think it is, yeah, it's going to be an extraordinary moment.
And also the fact that he will be free and safe in a city that experienced what it experienced in March is a really powerful message, isn't it?
Well, I think, you know, he said that in the statement that he issued, that this was one of the drivers for wanting to come to Christchurch, was the show of love and compassion, and all of the messages that went around the world in response to those tragic and terrible events of March 15. And it does align with his story of speaking truth to power and to actually being willing to take risks in order to tell the truth about the things that are happening, both back in Iran as a Kurdish writer, but also from Manus Island. And I just find it extraordinary that an entire book can be written on a WhatsApp application, just with all in Farsi and then translated into English and then going on to win such a prestigious prize.
Major, you know, prize. Yeah.
It really has been an extraordinary story from start to finish.
And if we back up the truck, the reason he had to flee Iran was because he was about to be arrested and almost certainly imprisoned for the work he was doing as a journalist there. So he is a remarkable man. As you say, he spent his life speaking truth to power. I want to go back to the Tampa and the arrival of the Tampa refugees in New Zealand. And boy, what fantastic New Zealanders they have turned out to be. And who was Minister of Immigration at the time, Lianne Dalziel?
Yes, I was. And, you know, I've remained friends today with a number of the people who came on the Tampa. They didn't come to Christchurch instantly. They were taken to Auckland, where they had their refugee status determined. They were all genuine refugees. This was not, you know, the fear tactics, I think, that were often used at the time. They were genuine refugees. They went through our very, you know, strict and fair determination process. They were determined to be refugees, and they were allowed to settle here in New Zealand. And a number of them did come to Christchurch and became my very good friends.
Yes, and I know you're too polite to make the point, but once again, we did something that Australia was incapable of doing, and we're doing it with Behrouz Boochani here. And there's a powerful message about...
I think with the Tampa, John, with the Tampa, it was a circuit breaker. So there had been a standoff. There was no movement. There was just nowhere to go. And, you know, if this moment is a moment in history where there's another circuit breaker, then what a powerful, powerful message that would be.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. What happens? What's he going to do? I mean, he can do whatever he likes, really. He's got a word event in Christchurch, which I urge people to go to, but life is his.
Yeah, well, the purpose of coming is the word event, and it's an opportunity for him in person to tell his story. And I don't think that has happened, well, it hasn't happened anywhere in the world. Certainly he has appeared in the sort of TEDx events, but only by, by remote means.
Yeah.
This is the first time, so Christchurch, New Zealand, Ototahi Christchurch will be the first place in the world where he will stand and tell his story in freedom. And that is so powerful. So I'm so grateful to Rachel King and the incredible team at Word. We are so proud of our Word Festival in Christchurch. It means so much to us. And this is really, it's really just the peak, the pinnacle of what has been achieved over many, many years of that festival running.
Nicely put. Couldn't agree more. Lianne Dalziel, Mayor of Christchurch, who was there at the airport to welcome Behrouz Boochani, who has just landed.